If you've been paying attention to the honorable mentions, you've likely determined that the final character is indeed going to be a character from the prolific manga series Hirohiko Araki's JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. If you know me personally, then you definitely saw this character coming from a mile away. My number one favorite character of all time, as well as number one favorite JoJo character, is Rex Mohs from Scott the Woz. Just, oh my goodness, what a character. I honestly don't even know where to begin. From his first appearance in Homecoming, Rex has been a truly fascinating character. We are introduced to him with the immediate knowledge of what is the most essential aspect of his character. He is violently opposed to all forms of alcohol, drugs, violence, sex, and sex. While these are typically seen as admirable traits in a person, Rex's fatal flaw is in how he takes his hatred for these things too far. And most of all, he uses violence against them, despite hating violence itself. He nearly breaks Scott's hand to stop him from drinking a beer, and later on, he destroys an entire laptop because he thought it was a beer. How one could make such a mistake becomes clear later, but we'll get there. The rest of the episode is spent focusing on how this mental state of his isn't even set in stone, as some minimum mental conditioning forces him to be all for these things instead of against them. Fortunately, he recovers by the next time we see him, when he is brought to his untimely demise by the crazed murderer, Mr. Officer Steel Wool. So came the end for a magnificent character. He was short-lived, but not forgotten. That isn't all, though. Thanks to the efforts of some truly inspiring doctors, Rex was healed of his murderedness, although he was falsely diagnosed with zero-degree burns in the process. Even still, he was back on his feet, and to celebrate, he decided to drink. But since he doesn't like alcohol, to put it lightly, he decided to drink water, enough to the point where he nearly overhydrated himself to death's door. His devotion went so far that he nearly passed on for the second time in the span of a couple months. Unfortunately, that's just how Rex is. He has his beliefs, and he will die with them. While this is harmful to himself, there is some respect deserved for having his own beliefs and sticking to them so strongly. Rex is more than just his beliefs, though. He has his own hobbies and video games, and plenty of things that he does and does not like. In the Dark Age of Nintendo saga, we get to see his disdain for the Gex series, his hatred in tennis games that don't let him grow comically large, and his admiration for Chibi Robo Ziplash. It really helps flesh out his character, but not as much as him deciding to help Scott take out the anti-Gex. Even though this is the antithesis of the Gex series that he hates so much, and made up of several copies of the Chibi Robo game that he had grown fond for, he still decided to help his friend and fellow virgin Scott fight for what he believed in. This sums up Rex's character. He respects people with firm convictions. This is why Rex is so disappointed when Scott tries to get a girlfriend later on, and why he joined the intervention team to get Scott to like RPGs. He was mad that Scott was leaving him behind in their mutual interest of hating sex, and he was upset that Scott bought so many RPGs despite not being an RPG guy, even if Rex himself had no clue what that was. Speaking of which, the final layer is added to Rex in You're Not an RPG Guy, his love for the economy. And this love goes further than romantic love. In a moment of passion, he proclaims how much he would like to, well, F the economy. Despite his burning hatred of sex, even he could not avoid the deadly sin of lust when something he likes as much as the economy is the topic of conversation. Was this a remnant of his mental conditioning in Homecoming? Or perhaps his beliefs aren't as set in stone as he would like his friends to believe? Either way, it's safe to say that Rex truly is a nuanced character, and more than worthy of the number one spot. He really was the best sco, bro.